instruments of play 8 feet. Ready to present the last play, The Taming of the Shrew.
The Taming of the Shrew is a comedy by William Shakespeare. The main plot depicts the courtship of Petruchio and Katrina, a headstrong obedient shrew. She is the elder brother of Bartissa. Lucentio, a rich young man, loves Bianca, the younger brother of Bartissa. They secretly elope and get married. Petruchio claims Katrina with various anthological comments, and she becomes an obedient girl.
Enjoys. If I do, I'll send him to her father. I'll do
young tenor for Tetchio from Verona pays a visit to his friend and hears about the feisty kid. He sees her as a challenge, which he decides to place to. Before Potentia's house, enter Petricia and his men.
My best beloved and approved friend Potentia, and I think this is his house. Grumio, knock!
My old friend Grumio and my good friend Petricia, how you are at Verona?
We are all doing fine. How about you?
I have come here in a search of a rich wife. Do you know one rich enough to be my wife?
I can help you find a wife who is rich and beautiful. Her only fault is that she is totally unbearable. A total witch.
Tell me her father's name. I will see her.
Her father's name is Baptista Minola. A pleasant gentleman. Her name is Katrina Minola. Famous Lord Padua for scoring town.
And a baby.
God save you, Signor Premio.
Well, Matt.
This gentleman is willing to woo Katrina.
Who is he?
Does he know her faults?
I'm Petruccio of Verona, Antonio's son, a man well known throughout all Italy.
But will you put his wildcat?
Have I not stood in the middle of the battle, loud calls to my arms and trumpets sounding all around me? And you're worried how I react to a woman's tongue?
I promise we'll help you cool her.
Enter Petruccio and Bianca with her friend's guide.
Sister, this is unfair to me. Untie my hands.
What I want for you is to tell me which of your suitors seem like the best.
You must be kidding. Break it and tie my hands.
If that's a joke, I guess the rest was too.
Enter Baptista.
Why do you want to hurt your sister? She never did you any harm.
Baptista went up to the teacher and accepted the offer that Manus would take. Enter Baptista.
Gentleman of Verona, I have heard of the pleasant and gentle manners of your daughter, and I beg you, leave it and ask her to marry you.
You're welcome, sir.
Good morrow, if that's your name I hear.
They call me Katrina. That do talk of me.
Hearing the mildness praised in every tongue, my heart was still in booty. It was told you were rough and sullen, though art pleasant and sweet.
Now, Signor Petruccio, how fare you with my daughter?
We have gotten all along so well that Sunday is our wedding day.
I'll see you hang on Sunday first.
I don't know what to say. Well, give me your hands.
God give you joy, Petruccio. Call it a marriage.
Father, wife, friends, favorite. I'm off to Venice and Sunday is our wedding day.
Katrina is to be wed on Sunday. Now, on Sunday following, who assumes Bianca's greatest dowry shall have her love.
Enter Baptista, Remio, Dremio, Bianca, Lucentio, and Katrina.
Today is the day appointed for the wedding of Katrina and Petruccio. But there is no sign of grand groom.
I told you, he was a frantic fool, a bitter jester. He had no intention of going to the wedding. I wish I had never seen the man.
Enter Bianca.
So, Petruccio is coming in a new hat at the old west. A pair of old hats going to tear off and match up
with. I'm glad he's coming, however his wealth.
Petruccio and his archers. Dress the outlandish thing. Petruccio has her church, outlandishly dressed, and kissed her to Verona as soon as the marriage is pronounced.
You're welcome, sir.
Where is my cake? Where is my lovely bride?
Don't greet her in this disgraceful clothes. Go to my room and put on something of mine.
It's me she's marrying and not my clothes. I have to bid good morning to my bride.
So, to Bianca's love, my style of father like it. I will find a man to act the part of your father and make assurance of a princely sum. So, shall you marry Bianca with her consent?
I swear.
I will carry her away, marry secretly. For once, her hand is mine. I'll keep her mine despite of all the world.
Re-enter Petruccio, Katrina, Bianca, and Grumio. And Baptista.
Gentlemen and friends, thanks for bothering to come here. You all expected me to stay to the dinner, but I am at my leave now. Grumio, my horse!
Yes, my lord. I will ready the horses.
All right then. I won't leave today, not tomorrow either. I will leave when I'm good and ready. The door is open, sir. Feel free to use it.
Calm down, Kate. Please don't be angry.
I get angry. What is this? It is of yours.
Calm down, Kate. Don't be angry.
Father, be quiet. He will stay as long as I stay.
They shall go to the bridal dinner, Kate. As for my bonnie, Kate, you will be with me. I'll be the master of the things which Comedy.
Mistress, what's your opinion of your sister?
That since she's mad herself, she's married a madman.
Now, Lucentio, you may take the bridegroom's place and let Bianca take her sister's seat.
Enter Petruchio and Katharina.
You stupid, you unpolished dogs, I get no service and no respect from you. Where is the curtain which you have sent ahead?
Yes, sir, as permission.
Go, Raskin, go and fix the supper in.
Servants send away supper.
Pardon, dear father.
Where is Lucentio?
Here is Lucentio.
of her life.
Mom, where Bianca?
Where's my father? Welcome.
And I, with equal affection, welcome yours.
Brother Petruccio, Sister Cassina, and you have a chair with the loving guys. You'll find no better entertainment anywhere else. All of you are welcome in my house.
All we do is sit and sit and eat and eat.
Padua is famous for its pleasant flower.
I wish it was true for both our sakes.
Hortensia is afraid of his wife.
Who is to say things to one is famous?
What's that supposed to mean?
What do you think of this quick-witted ghost, Grimio?
Believe me, sir, they work together well.
When heads are set to butting, it's time to butt us by retiring from the line. And go back to sleep now.
Seriously, Ghost and Petruccio, I think you have the most thoroughgoing shrew of us all.
Well, I disagree. But why not put it to a test? Let's each one send his wife, the one which is most obedient and comes out most readily, shall win the bet.
What's the bet?
100 crowns.
100 crowns, then?
Who shall begin?
I'm Bianca, being perfect.
We are well, open your mistress come to me.
I go.
So, my mistress sends you word that she's busy and cannot come.
What? Is that an answer?
You then, grandmother, go to my wife and tell her to come straight away to me.
Worse, worse! Grumio, are you there? Go call your mistress and tell her I commanded her to come to me.
No need to say, she will not come.
Well, let's hurry. Here comes Katrina.
You sent for me, sir. Go call your sister and Hortensio's wife.
You have won the wager. I will add 20,000 crowns than what they owe you.
Katrina, I would like you to tell this headstrong woman what duties wives and husbands owe each other.
Girls, girls, wipe the frowns off your faces and stop rolling your eyes. Your husband is your lord, your knight, your keeper, your sovereign, one who cares for you and who commits his body to harsh labor, both in land and sea. Humble your pride and show your loyalty. We'll bring him comfort.
There, that's my girl. Come, get Bill to bed. Here, I want the weather as the winner. Here I say goodbye.
So now, let me introduce you to the cast of the play. Supreme as Princess of Sky, Nicolaitan as Hostess, Lakshmi Prasanna as Lord,